It's finally time for a new ant colony introduction here on the channel. And not any colony, no. I got a very special species sent to me by the Ant Lady. I would also like to inform you that this video is sponsored by the Ant Lady. Wait till the end of the video where I will tell you more about the Ant Lady and the products and ants she has to offer. Alright, let's get straight into this video where you can see me unboxing the package. I was kinda expecting a pink box, but it was blue. When I opened the package, I was greeted with very nice pink tissue paper and the Ant Lady's logo. Next to the new ants, I got this cute cotton candy ant sugar. I like the fact that the logo is on the bottle. It just feels more personal, you know. Next, the ants, of course. That's why we are all here. The ants were wrapped in tin foil, and I struggled a little bit on how to take it off. I don't want to disturb the ants. And there they are. What a beautiful Campanulus discolor colony. Further in this video, I will tell you a little bit more about the species, so stay tuned. I absolutely love these ants. Look at how beautiful they are. The colors on the queen are very pretty, and the workers just look cute. They are definitely a lot different than my other Campanulus species that have a darker color. It's also funny that the larvae have a light pink tint to them. They get the color from the cotton candy the ant lady has fed them. The ants came well fed and in a very clean test tube with brood and workers. Plus points in my regard. Because this colony had quite a few workers and there wasn't too much room in the test tube, I decided to connect them to my mini outworld. I knew that the test tube the ant lady uses is the exact same one I use. Don't ask me how I know, it's a long and boring story. Anyway, they connected super easily. I also connected a second tube with water, because the tube they came in didn't have much water left in it. Of course, I chose a pink outworld, because that's the Ant Lady's color. If you are thinking, hey, that outworld is looking handy dandy, then look in the description where you can find a link to my store. Alright, enough with the ads, let's get back to the ants. I decided to do a little taste test with these ants. I gave them some blue ant liquid and cotton candy from the Ant Lady. Well, you can see what they like most. And to be honest, I can't blame them. It really tastes like cotton candy and I might need to order a bottle just for me. I left the ants alone for a long time. Because I was quite busy, I haven't looked at them for a month or so. I kept feeding them once a week some Mario worms, fruit flies, and the cotton candy ant sugar. And as you can see, this colony is still doing great. They have around 8 pupae, and by the time of writing this script, one more worker just enclosed this morning. I noticed because the empty shell is laying in the outworld. The ants also switched test tubes, which was very nice because I could replace the empty one very easily. The ants themselves are super active and always running around in the test tube and second test tube. I love them. Feeding them is a challenge since they run fast and are active, but so far I haven't encountered any problems. Yes, they might walk on the edge of the outworld. Just don't freak out and be patient. They usually walk straight back in. I like these mini outworlds since feeding the ants is so much easier than having to disturb the queen in the test tube. I know I'm simping a little bit too much for these outworlds, but you can be sure I wasn't using them myself if I didn't like them. I gave the ants a fruit fly and they attacked it like crazy. The fruit fly was already frozen, so they were acting a bit overdramatic. While we are watching these workers, let me tell you a little bit about this species. All the information comes directly from the Ant Lady's website, Of course, there will be a link in the description. So, Campanulus discolor is an American species that is found throughout the East Coast. This species in particular is caught around Alabama. They usually nest in wood, like all Campanulus species. The queen is around 12 to 13 millimeters, and like Campanulus, they can produce supermajors that can get between 10 and 12 millimeters big. They accept many types of food and love sugars. This species does not hibernate, so for me, this is an exciting new species to have. They are pretty uncommon, and definitely on YouTube, not much is documented about them. That's why I'm honored to care for this species and make videos about these ants. When I get enough of them, I will make a detailed care guide about this species. Personally, I think a care guide can only be made once I cared for at least a full year for the species, so I can help people that are about to order this colony through their first year. Oh, and these ants are doing some weird dancing inside a test tube. They can drink from the cotton, I double checked that. They're just pulling on the cotton and almost spinning it. Very funny. I want to thank the Ant Lady for sponsoring this video and providing me with this colony. If you don't know the Ant Lady already, then go check her out now. Link is in the description. The Ant Lady is a very passionate keeper that sells a lot of diverse species. She's UK based, but ships to other countries as well. She's not only very experienced, but a real gem to the ant keeping community. I'm Gen Z, so I don't use Facebook too much, but the Ant Lady, however, is replying to every question and helping everyone care for their ants. In my opinion, these are the best stores. The ones that are actively participating in the ant keeping community. Again, check out the Ant Lady, link in the description. And that brings us to the end of this video. I really enjoyed making this one. Did you as well? Let me know in the comments down below. Before I go, I will kindly ask you to like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Alright, see you guys later. Bye.